What's up, everybody? It's your girl Jessica Marie, and I am back with another video. Today we're going to be checking out the Mamas and the Papas, California Dreamin'. Now, when I hear this song, I've heard the song so many times, and I think we've all heard it on many different avenues when it comes to entertainment. But the main thing I think about is my sister had this song for many years as her ringtone. So whenever I think of this song and I hear it, I think of my sister's ringtone because she had this for a long time. And I am born and raised from Cali. And so I'm very, very excited to hear this song. This is my song to some degree because I am a California native. Even though Cali is not the greatest place to be right now, but that is where I'm born and raised. So I'm very excited to check out this song, and I hope you guys are too. So let's get into it. The Mamas and the Papas, California Dreamin'. Let's go. And the Papas, California Dreamin'. This group has a really interesting story. Their chemistry was very organic. They didn't last that long as a group together. And I know earlier with the, what is it, Gary Puckett and the Union Gap band, I was talking about young ladies in that song, Young Girls. I was discussing how a lot of the young women back then were obviously trying to talk to older men. And it just so happens that the skinny girl who was in the Mamas and the Papas and the taller gentleman, when they met, she was like 16. And he was a lot older than her. And he was married and they had an affair and they started messing around. And according to her, She basically went to his house and told his wife about it and told her that they was messing around and basically took this wife's husband away from his wife. And they got together and became an item, and then this same girl, she ended up messing with the other guy in the group, who the other lady in the group actually liked that guy, the shorter guy who led this song. I know the other lady, I do not think she's here with us anymore. I think she, from what I researched, she died of heart failure. Some people thought it was drugs or something, but according to the autopsy, it was heart failure. So it's very sad because she was just getting going with her solo career because she decided to leave the group. It was the group near the end of their time being together. They became very toxic for each other. Everybody kind of just, I don't think anyone really took this group very seriously, like maybe they should have, but I know a lot of them were, into drugs and stuff like that, so I'm sure that played a part. But regardless to that, they left us some great music while they were a group, and I loved California Dreamin'. Great voices, great composing, and the man who wrote most of the music and composed it was the man who was married, who ended up messing with the other girl. And that's how she got in the group, because he was trying to make music, and he said, "Well, why don't you be in the group too?" And he thought he could have double the money, is what I believe he said. This is a great song. Great song, great voices. They actually were a really great group. It's unfortunate they didn't take it a little more serious, but not every group is meant to stay together. They definitely left behind a lot of great music from their group. So let me know how you guys felt about the Mamas and the Papas and the California Dreamin'. Let me know in the comment section below. If you have anything else you'd like to recommend to me, please leave that in the comment section below. Also, you guys, don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe. And with that being said, you guys, stay safe, stay blessed, and I will see you in the next video. All right, y'all. Bye.